So today, I'm actually making a 4-pound batch, but I'm splitting it into 2 pounds. Because half of the batch, it's not going to have any colors in it. It's just going to be a plain goat milk soap at request of my in-laws. Then I'll start working on my Georgia soap. So you're going to see 2 batches in 1 video. The fragrance that I'm using for this plain soap is brown sugar and fig mixed with a little bit of mistletoe. So let's get started. Got the plain soap done. Alright, now let's move on to our Georgia soap. I'm going to be adding the fragrance Peach Nectar. Has top notes of mandarin, raspberry, and coconut, middle notes of peach, plum, and violet, base notes of vanilla and sugar. And it's a delicious sweet peach smell. I'm going to add a tablespoon of honey. You can tell me why I'm adding honey when you hear about the Georgia facts. And the colors I'm going to be using is a pink, an orange, and a tiny bit of apple green. And I still have soap on it from the batch that I just made. Let's make this Georgia soap. Georgia, the 4th state, abbreviated GA, joined the United States on January 2nd, 1788. The capital of Georgia is Atlanta. Georgia has a couple nicknames. First is the Peach State. It's called this for the importance of peaches in the Georgia agricultural economy. Georgia is also known as the Empire State of the South. This nickname represents a determination in the Georgia citizenry to be leaders in industrial and economic development in the southern tier of the states. Georgia's motto is wisdom, justice, moderation. It's always good to have moderation, isn't it? Their anthem is Georgia on my mind. The way Georgia was named is probably the easiest story, and it's named after England's King George II in 1733. Citizens of Georgia are known as Georgians. Georgia's flag bears 3 stripes consisting of red, white, red, featuring a blue canton containing a ring of 13 white stars encompassing the state's coat of arms in gold. In the coat of arms, the arch symbolizes the state's constitution, while the pillars represent the 3 branches of government. The words of the state motto, wisdom, justice, and moderation, are wrapped around the pillars, guarded by a male figure dressed in colonial attire from the American Revolutionary War. Within the arms, a sword is drawn to represent the defense of the state's constitution with an additional motto, In God We Trust. The ring of stars that encompass the state's coat of arms represents Georgia as one of the original 13 colonies. The design principle is based on the first national flag of the Confederacy, which was nicknamed the Stars and Bars. Georgia's colors are red, white, gold, and blue, which we see right there on the flag. Their state amphibian is the American green tree frog, probably one of the cutest frogs you'll ever see. The state bird is the brown thrasher. Their state insect is the European honeybee, same as New Jersey. They also have a butterfly, and it's the same as Delaware's, that is the eastern tiger swallowtail. Georgia has 3 state fish, the largemouth bass, the southern Appalachian brook trout, and the red drum. They've got 2 state flowers, the Cherokee rose and the azalea. Their mammal is the white-tailed deer, just like Pennsylvania. Georgia has a marine animal, which is the right whale, not the wrong whale, the right whale. Their state reptile is the gopher tortoise. They also have a state shell, and it is the same as New Jersey's, which is the knobbed whelk. Their state tree is the southern live oak. Very cool looking tree. It looks like one of those trees that would be in a storybook or in a Tim Burton movie. Their fossil is a shark tooth. They have a state mineral called starolite, and a state gemstone, which is quartz. Georgia has a state food, and that is grits. Curious if you have had grits and if you like grits. I know if you grew up in the South, grits are like a staple. But since I grew up in the North, I only just had grits first time like 10 years ago, and they're okay. But I've never had grits served to me by someone from the deep South of the US. Not surprisingly, their state fruit is the peach. They also have a state vegetable called the Vidalia sweet onion. Georgia's agricultural economy consists of peanuts, pecans, cotton, tobacco, soybeans, corn, sweet potatoes, peaches, chicken eggs, broilers, clay, and kaolin clay. I think some of us soapers recognize that word. Also, Fuller's Earth, which I've never heard of before, crushed stone, and granite. I thought it was so odd that it's down south when states 1 through 3 are in the northern part. I have not researched why Georgia is the 4th state and not a state touching Delaware, Pennsylvania, or New Jersey, but it is the official 4th state. Here we are the next day. I'm first going to unmold my little puppy prints because I'm really curious about them. You could also say they're kitty prints, but I think they're originally supposed to be puppy prints. Oh, they're cute. Cute little goat milk puppy prints. Man, I love silicone molds. They are so easy. It's amazing. And then what is this mysterious mold I filled up? I didn't say anything about it, did I? I was silent. Well, let's find out. Hopefully it worked all right. Well, I didn't quite get it all the way. There's an air pocket right on the nose, but this is a little mouse and a little leaf. This was kind of a thick batter. Did you notice the acceleration? I wanted to show you. It got pretty hot. Got some cracks. And it's really hard. And now, our Georgia soap. Here we go. Beautiful. We're gonna go ahead and start with the goat milk soap. Since it's gonna mostly be all the same, it'll be a really fast cut. I'm cutting it all the way to the edge because I'm going to cut these side ones in half. Well, you see our nice circle in the middle because these are going to be some sample bars. Look at our square in there. So I believe this will all turn this color, this darker color. And the green on top is supposed to be like the little peach leaves. Let's see if I have any swirl at all, because I did use 2 different colors here. So the movie reference for Georgia. Gone with the Wind. Gone with the Wind is a 1939 American epic historical romance film. It is set in the American South during the Civil War, which was from 1861 to 1865, between the North and the South. Gone with the Wind tells the story of Scarlett O'Hara, who is a strong-willed Southern Belle daughter of a Georgia cotton plantation owner. Well, she's an extremely spoiled girl. And throughout the movie, you see the hardships she goes through and how mean she is. But it's definitely, oh, there's some honey, I think. I think it's definitely a movie you should see if you like watching movies. It's an American classic film there. It's really long, so be prepared to watch a really long movie. So my question for you, have you ever been to Georgia? I have not ever been to Georgia, but my husband was born in Columbus, Georgia. I have been at the Atlanta airport, but I never really count sitting at an airport as visiting the state because you don't even get to experience the state. You don't even get to experience the people. All right, let's stamp these soaps. I hope you enjoy the short clip from Gone with the Wind as my Georgia movie reference. Thank you for watching. I also hope that you enjoyed the little facts that we have learned together about Georgia. I know I have enjoyed it.
We've sort of shocked the Confederacy, Scarlett.
It's a little bit like blockade running, isn't it?
It's worse. But I expect a very fancy profit out of it.
Well, I don't care what you expect or what they think. I'm going to dance and dance. Tonight I wouldn't mind dancing with Abe Lincoln himself.
Georgia on my mind.